Hey guys, it's Tiffany from supereasymath.com. Today's math problem of the day says 2/3 times parentheses 1/3 plus 3/5. Well, this is an order of operations problem, so I always like to write PEMDAS at the top of my paper or wherever I'm working. Then I like to clarify that the M and D, or multiplication and division, work together at the same time, and so do addition and subtraction. For this problem, we do have a set of parentheses, and inside we have two fractions that we need to add. The first problem I notice is that we don't have a common denominator, and in order to add fractions, you do need to have a common denominator. So I'm gonna work on just this portion of the problem, not the whole thing, because I need to get common denominators. So now I'm gonna work on just this portion of the problem. So I've rewritten it over here because I need to get that common denominator. I already know that the least common multiple between 3 and 5 is going to be 15, so I've rewritten the denominators of our new fractions with the denominator of 15. Now I'm looking at the 3, and I ask myself to go from 3 to 15, what did I multiply the 3 by? And that was by 5, and I need to do the same on the top. So it's 1 times 5, and that would be 5. Over here, 5 times what gives you 15? That would be 5 times 3, and so I multiply by 3 on the top as well. So 3 times 3 is 9. Now I need to bring down my addition sign, so I'm just adding here. That's 5 plus 9 is 14 over 15. Now I'm going to continue with the rest of my problem, which is really just this portion. 2/3 times, instead of writing all of this, I'm going to write what I just calculated it to equal, the 14 over 15. And when you're multiplying fractions, you multiply straight across. You do not need to worry about getting a common denominator. 2 times 14 is 28, 3 times 15 is 45. That fraction cannot be simplified, so the answer to this order of operations problem is 28 over 45. Here's tomorrow's math problem of the day. See if you can solve it before I do, but don't forget to head over to supereasymath.com where you can get my top 5 math tips to make learning math easier.